here hasn't thought about all the species of animals and plants we might never get to witness just because they became extinct thousands of years before we were born? The loss of all these species can be attributed to uncontrolled human intervention and the drastic shift in climate over time. In fact, today the number of extinct species is far greater than the ones that are alive, though it's a shame there's not much we can do about it. Scientists, however, would have jumped at any opportunity to study and analyze even a single one of these wiped-out creatures. That's probably why they have been tirelessly working day and night to advance the field of genetics and perfect the art of cloning, for it is one prospective way to bring these animals and plants back from extinction. The odds are actually in their favor as they're getting closer to making it happen. But who here knows which species are a top priority for bringing back to life? Turns out, we do, and that's why in today's video we'll be enlightening you about the top 20 animals scientists are aiming to bring back to life. But before we get started, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell for more such amazing content. The dodo. Unfortunately, this bird became extinct just 30 years after it was discovered. Nobody has figured out how long these creatures have been around. The only known habitat of the dodo was Mauritius Island. It probably lived here peacefully before being detected by explorers and scientists. It's been reported that the dodo population started drastically falling around the 1590s. A unique behavioral character this bird manifested was the absence of any fear regarding humans. The reason behind it was that this bird had never witnessed people before, which is also why it was easy to capture this bird and kill it. Dodos aren't like your average birds. They're comparatively large and quite heavy, with their average height being around 3 feet, their average weight estimated to be around 35 to 40 pounds. Turns out there's a good chance that the dodo might come back to life, for all the scientists need to do is gather a few DNA samples and implant these into the closest relative species. Can you guess which species it is? Okay, we'll tell you. It's the pigeon. Amazing, right? The ground sloth. The giant sloth is often mistaken for a bear, especially by people who've never seen this creature before. But as much as it might resemble a bear, it's actually not one. This ground sloth is a species scientists are pretty keen to bring back, because according to research, these animals were walking the earth not so long ago. And unlike other species, the work in bringing these back has gained a steady pace thanks to the already collected DNA samples extracted from their undamaged cells. The real problem arises when trying to find an appropriate surrogate mother to carry the sloth baby, as their closest relative available nowadays is too small. It is kind of impossible for them to carry a creature the size of a bear. That's probably why scientists are thinking about creating an artificial womb to sustain this future sloth baby. This might actually work. What do you say? The woolly mammoth. Although science believes that most of the woolly mammoths perished around 10,000 years ago, a population of around 500 to 1,000 lived on Wrangel Island up to 4,000 years ago. The mammoth was huge and heavy, almost the size of an African elephant. Its shoulder height has been estimated to be around 11 feet, with an average mammoth weighing around 6 tons. The animal had a thick double-coated layer of fur and fluffy ears to aid in survival, as these animals lived in a time of harsh climatic conditions. Many specimens of the mammoth have been discovered in the Arctic and have therefore made it possible for scientists to use their DNA and create a hybrid embryo of the woolly mammoth along with an elephant. They like to call it mammophant. Cool, right? The Neanderthal. This is by far one of the most controversial propositions of science. There's a lot of heated debate regarding the subject of bringing this species back and the way it'll be made possible. The logistics are under scrutiny, as there are a lot of ethical and moral concerns associated with this experiment. It's no secret that the most appropriate surrogate option for the Neanderthal has to be a human. Also, the Neanderthals are considered a subspecies of modern human beings, and therefore cloning them might revolutionize science, and it would be quite unethical. But the fact stands that cloning Neanderthals would probably be the easiest task as compared to other species, as we have the genus, the surrogate, and the DNA to make it happen. The real question here is whether we should. The woolly rhinoceros. This one is also a huge fluffy animal that went extinct like the woolly mammoth, and scientists really want to bring it back. The woolly rhino was a resident of the Arctic snows around 10,000 years ago and is pretty famous in pop culture. It frequently makes an appearance in Chauvet Arc Cave. This mammal has been perfectly preserved thanks to the Arctic permafrost, and therefore quite a lot of specimen is available for study and attempting resurrection. Because of its similarity to the mammoth, this rhino has more or less the same chances of being brought back to life. The Barji River Dolphin. You'd be surprised to find out that this beloved river animal went extinct only 15 years ago in the year 2006, and it happened all because of excessive and hazardous human activity. The prospects of bringing this animal back from extinction are great, and scientists think they'll be successful in doing it pretty soon. Their DNA is readily available, and cloning is already considered a success. There is, however, one problem. No one knows whether this dolphin will have a habitat to come back to in case it is brought back from the dead, as their previous habitats are extremely polluted. This pollution was what led to their extinction in the first place. The moa. The moa was a massive bird that could not fly and looked almost exactly like the ostrich. This is a pretty diverse species with around 10 members, some of which are barely as big as turkeys, while others are thought to have reached a height of 10 feet. It's actually considered the largest bird to have ever inhabited the Earth. This bird hasn't been gone for long, though. The moa went extinct only 600 years ago because it was being excessively hunted by humans. The remnants of the feathers and eggs of this animal are easily found even today because they didn't go extinct that long ago. The moa DNA has been extracted from its eggshells and is being analyzed for cloning. The Irish elk. The Irish elk is also often called the giant deer. This animal was among the few unfortunate species that couldn't survive the Ice Age. Although it was believed to have gone extinct around 12,000 years ago, scientists have been successful in excavating elk fossil that is seemingly only 7,000 to 8,000 years old. The fossils have been found in Siberia. We have to say that if it is resurrected, the elk would be one majestic sight to see. After all, this 7-foot-tall animal with antlers extending up to 12 feet across isn't something you see every day. The heath hen. The heath hen is one species that managed to catch the attention of a lot of people. These birds were commonly found in the northeastern areas of the US and were subject to aggressive hunting for the coming 300 years. They were mostly hunted to be used as food. Although locals banned the hunting of this bird in an attempt to prevent extinction, it was futile and the bird was lost for good in the year 1932. Due to its recent extinction, DNA is readily available for scientists to attempt resurrection, but there's a conservationist group that's determined to bring it back using genetic technology. The gastric brooding frog. This is an aquatic frog species native to eastern Australia. This one is quite unique as its genus consists of only 2 species. Unfortunately, both these species fell victim to extinction because of the chytrid fungus in the 1980s. These frogs have a very peculiar feature. Turns out they give birth through their mouths. It wasn't until the year 2013 that scientists started working on a project called the Lazarus Project, in which they tried to clone this frog in hopes of making an embryo that could survive up to the tadpole stage at least. The quagga. The quagga is actually a subspecies of the plain zebra. It went extinct in the year 1983 because of excessive hunting like most other animals. Both the zebra and the quagga have the same DNA and genotype, but their phenotypical characteristics may differ to some extent. Scientists have been working on a project that aims to resurrect the quagga using selected plain zebras. This project was somewhat of a success, as the first quagga plain zebra was actually born in the year 2005 and has been able to reproduce up to the 5th generation in the year 2013. This new quagga is the same as its extinct ancestors and therefore can be released into the wilderness. The thylacine. The thylacine is considered to be the world's largest known carnivorous marsupial. Like most other marsupials, it is native to Australia. This creature looked a lot like a wolf. In the mainland, this animal went extinct around 3,000 years ago, but miraculously, it survived to live on a Tasmanian island until human hunters ruthlessly wiped it out to protect themselves in the late 20th century. Scientists at the University of Melbourne were known to grow a massive embryo from the DNA extracted from thylacine remains, and this embryo actually grew normally. Therefore, now they're hopeful that the thylacine can be brought back from extinction. The Megalania. The Megalania is known for being a part of the megafauna assemblage that lived in the south of Australia during the Pleistocene era. The Megalania were massive creatures weighing more than 500 kilograms and were around 5.5 meters tall. Some scientists believe that the earliest Aborigine settlers of Australia might have been the cause behind the extinction of this huge lizard. The scientists are quite interested in retrieving the megalania, although we're not sure why. It seems pretty scary, to be honest. The Great Auk. The auk is a flightless bird that went extinct not that long ago. It was present until the mid-19th century. It was considered the only modern species in the genus called Pinguinus, even though there's no relationship whatsoever between the auk and the penguin. And still, the auk was the first bird ever to be called a penguin. The feathers of this bird were used in making pillows and therefore were in high industrial demand, especially in Europe. Moreover, its eggs and flesh were also used for food. These and many other reasons contributed to its extinction, but scientists believe they'll be able to clone this one-of-a-kind bird shortly. The auroch. The auroch is considered the ancestor of all modern cattle. Cool, right? It turns out this animal was domesticated by settlers of India and Eurasia around 10,000 years ago. But sadly, this historic parent species was deemed extinct in the 17th century when the last auroch perished from disease. Scientists plan to bring back this species by backbreeding the primitive European cattle breeds until they manage to achieve a creature similar to the auroch. Well, good luck to them. The passenger pigeon. The passenger pigeon existed in huge numbers. Billions of them were alive at the same time, actually, before their numbers started falling. The bird was native to America and used to migrate in the form of massive flocks. This allowed humans to be able to shoot them down in large numbers, and with time, this led to a decrease in their population until the species went extinct. Scientists are making efforts to bring it back with the help of the band-tailed pigeon and have actually announced that it'll be ready by 2024. Pyrenean ibex. The Pyrenean ibex is a subspecies of the Spanish ibex. Because it was frequently hunted for meat around 200 years ago, their population started dwindling and they went extinct about 20 years ago. Not that long, to be honest. This species, however, is a scientific miracle as soon as after going extinct in the year 2000, scientists managed to bring it back in just 6 years. Though it couldn't survive and died in a few minutes because of a respiratory deformity, it did set the precedent for the successful revival of extinct species by cloning. Scientists are still hopeful that they'll be able to bring this animal back. All they need is some viable genetic material. The Carolina parakeet. This North American bird was eradicated from the face of the earth by hunters in the year 1939. Poachers used to hunt this bird for its unique and stunning feathers that were then used to produce expensive hats for ladies. Thankfully, scientists have managed to extract their DNA from eggshell remains and are trying to revive this beautiful bird. The saber-toothed tiger. This extinct animal is nearly the size of a modern-day large feline. If scientists brought it back, we'd be able to witness 13 feet tall tigers weighing anywhere between 200 to 600 pounds. The saber-toothed tiger used to have a thick muscular neck, agile and powerful limbs, and characteristic sharp teeth protruding from the upper jaw. This carnivorous predator went extinct only 11,000 years ago, and since they were dwellers of the cold regions, their fossils have been greatly preserved by nature. Maybe this is one extinct animal we shouldn't try to bring back. The Siberian unicorn. If you ever wondered how a real unicorn would look, here's your answer. Turns out it resembles a huge rhino instead of a majestic horse. The fossils of the Siberian unicorn found in Kazakhstan points that the species went extinct merely 29,000 years ago. Previously, scientists thought it had been gone much longer than this. If scientists managed to bring it back, some people would be really happy, for they'd get to witness an actual unicorn. The Siberian unicorn was around 12 feet long, 15 feet tall, and weighed a massive 9,000 pounds. Incredible, right? We have just one question. What are we going to do with it if it does get resurrected? We hope you guys enjoyed this video. Do tell us in the comments which one of these you would like to see alive again. We'll be back soon with another smashing and mind-boggling fact film for you guys. See you all next time. Have a great day.